Hey guys, this is PAISTEBOY here, and today I'm doing a collaboration video with Dave from MyOldSled channel on the rules and regulations of snowmobiling. He'll be doing the rules and regulations on Ontario, Canada, and I'll be doing mine on New York State in the United States. So, say hi, Dave.
Hey, PAISTEBOY. One of the first guys I ever watched on YouTube. Thanks for agreeing to help out. I get a lot of requests about information related to rules and regulations. Shout out to Darian, recently sent me a question about insuring your snowmobile. So I thought I'd do a video. One of the things that occurred to me is that a lot of my viewers are from all over the world, and PAISTEBOY, I'm sure you have the same thing. So yeah, I thought it'd be great. We'll do a little collaboration. But again, bear in mind that the information in this video is regarding Ontario and New York, respectively, as of this year. So when you finish watching the video, make sure you take the time to look into the rules and regulations in your own state or province. Okay, so first question, do you need a license to ride a snowmobile in Ontario? Well, if you're going to take it off your property, yes, you need one of two things. You either need one of these guys, a valid Ontario driver's license, if you're 16 or older. If you don't have a driver's license or you are 12 or older, you can get a motorized snow vehicle license as well. So it's a short course, which is actually a good idea. I mean, these machines, you can really hurt yourself on one of these machines. So, you know, if you've got young kids, it's not a bad idea for them to take a course on using one of them safely. But if you go to the OFSC website, and I'll put that up on your screen, they'll issue a motorized snow vehicle license at the conclusion of the course. So either a valid Ontario driver's license or a motorized snow vehicle license.
Question is, do you need a license to operate a snowmobile in New York State? The answer is no, not necessarily. You don't need a driver's license, but if you are under the age of 18, you do require something. So if you are between the ages of 10 and 14, you will need to take a safety course that New York State offers, and I believe it's free. So there's no charge for that. But if you are 14 and you've taken the course, between 14 and 18, with the course being taken, you can ride the snowmobile by yourself. You don't need another adult with you. If you are between 10 to 14, then you have to still have an adult with you.
Next question, do I need insurance to drive a snowmobile? If you got a huge piece of land and you can, you know, you live on a farm and you can ride around on your own fields, then you're good. But if you're taking your snowmobile off the property, then yes, you need to get insurance. I'm not really going to talk much about, you know, providers or costs, because insurance varies hugely depending on a lot of factors. What snowmobile are you riding? How old are you? What's your driver's record like? Etc. You're going to kind of need to look into that yourself. I just insured mine through my house insurance. And it wasn't terribly expensive, but yes, you do need insurance.
Well, basically, the only reason you need insurance is if you want to protect your machine, you can get insurance, you know, as far as comprehensive fire theft liability. But if you leave your property, you are required to have insurance. Plain and simple.
So if you're coming up to visit us for some snowmobiling in Ontario from outside the province or outside of Canada, all the MTO website says is that you are required to have whatever license you need to ride a snowmobile in your own province, state, or country.
If you're not a resident in New York State, you will need a non-resident registration. And if you could do that online, as long as you're a U.S. Resident, but if you live in Canada, you actually have to go to the Department of Motor Vehicles to get this registration.
So the other thing to remember is before driving a snowmobile, it has to be registered with the Ministry of Transportation through a Service Ontario Centre. So with a new snowmobile, it needs to be registered within 6 days of sale. So this is one thing I used to wonder about, because I would see some snowmobiles had it looked like a license plate on the side. So you do have to have your registration numbers on the sled. Most times nowadays you'll see custom numbers that are actually on the side of the sled. The dealers usually put them on. But otherwise, you do have that have to have that plate on the sled.
When registering your snowmobile, you could either go to the DMV or you could do it online if it's a renewal. If it's the first time you're registering your snowmobile, you'll have to actually go to the DMV. If you bought it used, that's your only option. But if you bought it new, the dealer can do the registration for you. All you have to do is sign the paperwork when you're buying the sled. What do you do for registration numbers? Well, in New York State, they have to be put on the upper portion of the hood. And in this case, I just bought this sled brand new this year, and there's no good place to put it on the upper portion of the hood. Okay, so you can see I put mine on the lower portion of the side panel. I mean, these rules were kind of set when snowmobiles were shaped a lot different, more like my older sled here, or like the one Dave has. So you can see here on the upper portion where they want you to put it, I have a vent. And there isn't enough room around that vent to actually put that sticker. So I put it down on the lower portion, and I actually did that on my old sled here too. But they do say that if you don't have your registration sticker on the sled, there could be up to a $200 fine and registration revocation. Now you saw that little red sticker that said 16 on it. That has to go in the corner on the registration number sticker. When you re-register your sled or register it for the first time, that has to be placed in the left-hand corner.
Okay, there's also a sticker that you need to have. Now, if you had your plate here, then it would have to go in the corner of the plate. My registration numbers are here. So you do have to get an annual renewal on your sticker, just like you do with a car. Alright guys, in this day and age it's probably pretty obvious, but you are required to wear a helmet when you operate your snowmobile off of your own property. And I'd go so far as to say even on your own property, it's a darn good idea to protect your head. But the other thing you may not realize is that anybody who's riding on a toboggan or anything towed by a snowmobile is also required to wear a helmet in Ontario.
Well, if you're riding on your own property, you're at your own risk. I recommend wearing a helmet. I know when I was younger I didn't, but we didn't do a lot of off our own property riding, so we didn't have helmets yet. But we also had smaller snowmobiles, we weren't going so fast, we were in our backyards, we had some property. But if you drive off of your property, you are required to wear a helmet by law. One other thing, if you're towing something like a toboggan or a sleigh, that has to be with a rigid tow bar. You can't have a rope or chain or anything that would create slack. It has to be rigidly attached to the snowmobile. That's the only allowed way you can tow.
So let's talk about where you can ride your snowmobile. Now this is something you probably want to check on the Ministry of Transport's website because you really want to get this right. But basically on the larger 400 series highways like the QE, the 403, you can't ride a snowmobile at all. You can't even cross the highway. Most other highways, it's okay to cross. So you want to make sure you come to a full stop and then you cross. Now you can ride along a roadway, but you should keep as far away from the road surface as possible. So between the shoulder and the fence line.
Well, you can ride on the shoulder of the road as long as it's leading to a trail. And there are 10,500 miles of trails in New York State, all of which you're able to ride on without a permit, with the exception of Old Forge, New York, which does require a permit. They do not accept any funding from the state. They operate and maintain those trails solely on selling the permits. If you buy a permit before November 15th, as of this year, it was $65. If you buy it after November 15th, it will cost you $85. Now, if you join a club, the club also gets funding from the state, and that's how the rest of the trail system in New York State is maintained. So when you register your sled, it will cost $100. But if you join a snowmobile club in the state of New York, you get a discount. So the club may cost you $25 or $30 to join, but now your registration fee goes down to $45. As far as where you can ride also on roads and things, if it's a state of emergency, you're allowed to literally ride on the roads because you may be able to assist people that are in, you know, a stalled car or whatnot. So in the state of emergency, you've got a lot more options of riding in New York State. Now, I understand in Canada, at least in Ontario, they have two different permit prices to ride on their trail system. If you have a classic sled, Dave will explain that to you. But here in New York State, every snowmobile registration is one fixed price, which I discussed. It's $100 per snowmobile. If you join the club, it goes down to $45. And then you show your club voucher when you go to register your snowmobile. You can print that out online once you join the NYSSA. And then that'll get you your registration discount. Well worth it.
Hey, Pasty Boy, I'm glad you mentioned the trails. To me, that's the best place to ride. And if you check out some of my videos, you'll see some of the trails that we have in Ontario. So in Ontario, we have tens of thousands of kilometers of groomed snowmobile trails. They're managed by the Ontario Federation of Snowmobile Clubs, so the OFSC. If you're going to ride a snowmobile on one of the OFSC trails, you do need to have a trail permit. You can buy them online on the OFSC website, and we'll put that up for you. There's also restaurants in certain locations where you can buy a trail permit. So this year, I think a permit is $210. If you have a classic sled like I do, you save a little bit of money. I think I paid $140. So again, well worth it. It's a little bit of a gamble each year, right? Because you don't know what the winter is going to do, what the weather is going to be like. We haven't had much snow, and it hasn't been that cold, so a lot of the trails haven't been open yet. Got my fingers crossed. There's still plenty of winter left. But when those trails are open, it's amazing. You can jump on, you can ride all day long, meet up with other riders, stop for lunch along the route. It's really well worth it. Okay, if you're going to talk about trails, then you need to talk about speed limits. Now, don't shoot the messenger here, guys. If you're riding in a park or a fairground, a public space like that, or if you're riding somewhere where the posted speed limit is less than 50 kilometers an hour, then on your snowmobile, you're limited to 20 kilometers an hour or lower. So on the remainder of the OFSC trails, the speed limit is 50 kilometers an hour. So for Pasty Boy and my other friends in the south, that is right around 30 miles per hour.
Is there a speed limit for snowmobiling in New York State? Well, there is. It's 55 miles per hour. I've really never seen anyone, pulled over for speeding on a snowmobile because there aren't very many snowmobile officers out there. They will pull you over if you have loud exhaust. They'll check for registration. They'll check for, insurance. But 55 is the max speed. Now, if you are within 100 feet of a house, then you are required to go the minimum speed to follow or to maintain forward motion. That is between midnight and 6 a.m. Now, if it's any other hours, then you are allowed to go, at a reasonable speed roadside. If you're on a trail and it happens to go by a house, well, then I suppose 55 miles per hour will still pertain in that case. But be smart about it. You don't want to be getting yourself into a dangerous situation by going too fast. I just had this brand new sled out over the past, earlier this week for the first time, and I didn't go crazy on it, but I was cautious because you never know what you're going to run into, so you got to be safe out there. If you want more information, check out the NYSSA website, and they have quite a bit of information there, some of which I covered, and, I want to thank you for watching this, and, we'll leave it over to Dave at My Old Sled. Thanks. Take care.
All right. Thanks again, Pasty Boy. And congratulations on that awesome new snowmobile. So, guys, I hope you found that useful. If you did, go ahead and hit like or subscribe. If you're watching it on my channel, then make sure you go ahead and jump over to Pasty Boy's channel. He's got a lot of great videos. If you're watching on Pasty Boy's video, jump over and have a look at mine. So thanks, and I'll catch you next time.